Women's double skulls away, Great Britain are away, just slightly tentative off the start there for the British crew in lane number four. Around them, up in lane one, the Czech Republic, New Zealand are in lane two, Australia, the world silver medalist who suffered that defeat at the hands of Great Britain, the Carapiro, last year. Australia are in three, Great Britain now are in lane number four, starting to find their power, starting to find their speed, and alongside them, Ukraine in five, and Poland in lane number six. That first and second stroke there from Catherine Granger, just coming off, getting into the race, easing it out.
Pressure on Catherine to make sure that she almost protects her doubles partner. She doesn't want to put too much strain on her, so she's going to try and lay down a lot of hard work there. Fastest qualifiers were Australia in the semi-final by 2 seconds, but Great Britain now have a very good half-length lead on Australia, and looking strong, well connected at the front end of the stroke, very good.
Real wonderful combination between Great Britain's Watkins and Granger, and Anna Watkins in the bow seat really allows Catherine to just excel. It's just been a fantastic meeting of minds here, and they are so optimistic. They're a great double to be around here. Their self-belief, but again, they're humble with it. You know, they just think about doing the training program and then racing to the best of their ability. Very, very humble. Wonderful double skull.
In the national trials, this coming selection trials back in April, Anna had overtook Catherine, who'd won the trials for 7 years running, and she overtook her and beat her. So she's the faster of the two scullers.
So through the first quarter of the race, and a little tentative in the first 10 strokes, but the British crew now have established what is a very, very dominant rhythm, and they go through in first place. Again, a brilliant position to be in here, because now the race can be dictated by you. You can now set the pace here. You have the confidence to come down into your race rhythm here and really start just pushing away those finishes and then opening up a speed. Just looking very, very relaxed. A little look right, a little look left from Anna, just checking where everyone is around, particularly Australia. And next to them, Crow and Kehoe, world silver medalists. There they are in lane number three. Not looking as long and flowing as the British crew.
Remember Catherine Granger, three times Olympic silver medalist, almost gave up after Beijing because she just wondered where she was going to get a gold medal, and then she decided to try herself out in a single skull. And 2 years ago she won the silver medal in the single skull, and she knew that she had it in her, because the single is a really tough event. So she's come back. She doubled up last year through the World Cups in the, she and Anna, they doubled up in the double and the quad through the World Cups, won five of the six races, and then they went and focused on this double. Australia hanging on there.
But Great Britain aren't really doing any fun. You know, they're doing all that is asked of them, all that is necessary at this stage. Containment in the first 1,000 meters. And again, because we're really starting to see you're pushing Anna Watkins back here into this sort of big high profile race. A lot of pressure going on here. All these crews here really looking to, you know, make a mark as they leave for their summer training camps. At the halfway mark, the final of the women's double skulls, and Anna Watkins and Catherine Granger from Great Britain are showing that things are again now looking to be almost back to normal. They're almost a length ahead here. Their first real proper test in the 2011 season here, and they must be very happy with where they are.
At Munich, Anna was injured, and Catherine teamed up with Melanie Wilson, who was the spare, and they won pretty convincingly in Munich. So this is getting Anna back, taking it pretty gradually, still just not wanting to put any big sprints in if they can help it, working very well there together.
Pressure though coming from Crow and Kehoe from Australia, who are now just still hanging on there. You can see perhaps going slightly quicker, the Australians. This is one and two from the, a repeat now, of the World Championship final last year in Carapiro, 750 meters to go. Last year in that World Championships, this double skull were way out and comfortable. Now they're having to really sort of fight for a little bit more. They're really kind of finding their speed and finding their way again.
Just watching them there, we just saw them lift the rate there, because it was looking a bit labored, it was looking a bit heavy as the Australians were challenging them. And I think they were just gearing up to make a move. But they made a move, went up to 36 strokes a minute, and I think they've held off the Australian challenge. But the Australians up at 38 strokes a minute now, reckoning that they have got a good chance of matching them, wanting to exploit Anna's hesitancy about her back.
Absolutely. This is the time where they really want to try and sort of, you know, cause some psychological damage. They're pushing hard, they're pushing hard, they're still coming back on it here now. And what we're going to see into the last 500 meters is a great race here. The Australians are in second, Great Britain are in first. It's first and second from the World Championships last year here. Everybody else racing for the bronze medal spread out across the course here. But Great Britain are holding again. Look at the length of stroke from the British crew. Granger from St. Andrew Boat Club, and a Watkins there from Leander Club, really thinking about being long and relaxed.
They've moved up. They were caught a little bit napping by the Australian challenge there in the middle. They wanted to try and keep control, and not have to do a sprint. But it got heavy doing that. So what they've done is to lift their rating. It looks much easier now. It's much livelier, and they're moving away from Australia. So Australia wanted to put pressure on Anna Watkins's back, see if they could break her down here before the World Championships. But I think she's looking very strong now. She's picking it up well now, and the boat looks much livelier as they come into the last 250 meters.
So the British crew moving out to a length over the world silver medalist from Australia, Crow and Kehoe. We're just looking at Ukraine, lane number 5. All these crews right back out of it. You're really thinking, look out front. Now the bit of clear water from Great Britain. They can enjoy the last bit up. They've done all that was asked for them in that middle 1,000 meters. And in that last 500, they really were held off a sustained attack from the Australians. But it's length, it's a solid back there from Anna Watkins. They've got inside 5 strokes. They can count them in, they can enjoy. It's a job well done. And when they look back at the gold medal they've won today, they'll see perhaps this was a very, very significant win over Australia.
Australia just closing a little bit again there at the end. So they were able to maintain that 36, 37 strokes a minute, Australia, right the way through. Slightly shorter stroke, but pretty lively. And I think that will be a good outing. First outing together, first race together for Catherine and Anna. That was a very, very good performance.